here on the test center. You can see here that we are actually at the title screen, and I'll show you why in just a little bit, but there's a couple of good reasons, believe me. So the first and most obvious reason is that we do have magic here. Yay, magic! And look, the second reason is coming by! Look, see, it's Spider-Man! Woo! So for those of you who don't know, and whether it's because you don't live here or whatever, here in the U.S., next week is Thanksgiving. So one of the famous things is that we have the Thanksgiving Day parade from me. Oh, man. Go away, tippy toe. Nobody wants you in the parade. And Spider-Man's been part of the parade for many, many years. Decades, actually. So this is so cool. We got the new title screen. Yay! It's fun. So I guess that means that we'll have a patch relatively soon, probably on Monday or something like that. But I just wanted to show that because I saw it and I thought it was so adorable. Except for Tippy Toe. You go away. Those balloons are cool, though. And Spider-Man was awesome. He's gone now, though. But still, most, by and large, is pretty awesome. So before I really get started, one thing I also wanted to mention is that I do greatly apologize for missing Monday. Basically, it's been a very long week and an exceedingly painful week for me, unfortunately. So I missed Monday for a very good reason, and now I'm here and sucks! Yay! So we'll go ahead and get started. I'm going to be messing around on the test center. We've got Magik back, and we also have the test center back with some much, much needed adjustments. So I'm going to just temporarily shut off the feed here, so that I can log in for you guys. So don't freak out. I'm not fancy like the Breviks. I don't have I don't have Hawkeye to cover up my email and password. There goes Spider-Man again. It's okay, we're logged in now. And Revenant's here. Holla at you, Revenant. Oh, whatever, squirrels. Well, see, that's the problem, Revenant, is just, like I said, it's just been a terrible week. Just awful. Jessica Jones, unfortunately, I actually haven't watched that. I've been meaning to, but I haven't, sadly. It looked pretty amazing. I mean, obviously, with Daredevil, they went the pretty hardcore, gritty, and dark reboot thing with it, and Jessica Jones really lends herself to that. So I think that they picked a good choice of character for this particular thing. Now, what was I gonna do? Right, Magik. I should still have her. I don't know if they actually did. Yeah, they didn't. I still have her at 60. And alternate warnings here too. That's interesting. It's been refunded for spec one only. Huh, cool. Interesting. Oh, right, yeah, because I didn't use spec two. Hadoo! Math. Math are hard. Y'all don't know. So, if y'all saw my stream last week, where I went over all of her powers and all that good stuff, you may notice that this is actually a different tree structure than what she had previously. They changed where some of her passive abilities are, where some of her vulnerability procs are, things of that nature. Particularly the limbo tree has drastically changed in terms of really what it just looks like. I won't mess around with her too much, though, simply because the powers themselves really haven't done much. I'm mostly going to focus on the the danger room. But yeah. So, EAG, I did get Battlefront, and I was seriously debating doing a stream on it, but then I just couldn't bring myself to, unfortunately. So, my lemonade's too hot. It's all good, though. Woo! I get lemonade all over my face. Delicious. See, this is the danger with filling your lemonade cup too full. Delicious carbonation. If you mean Magik's default costume, I believe it's this one, the one that I'm wearing right now. Look! I'm disgusting. I'll wake you up. And I already went to work. Ah! Oh, see, you guys can't see it anymore. Ooh. Mm. So inside of this cup now is just dry ice and my lemonade. Ah, and it's delicious. Delicious carbonation. Ah, because before it was too hot. Revenant knows what I'm talking about. You forgot the cost of laundering my shirt, though. See, that's at least several cents. And plus you get water vapor up your nose. It wakes you up. It's better than coffee. Way better than coffee. A pyramid? That's not a word. Now my nose tingles from all the vapor. Ah. That was fun, though. It's totally worth it. 120%. But to be fair, Revenant, the ice was free because I got it from Lab. Mmm. Sucker! Alright. We'll swap over to our good friend Rocket because we have had many changes to the Danger Room and that's what we want to work on. It's not really an experiment, no. It's just ice. Let me see if I can grab a piece. Ah, delicious. Here, I'll swap back so I can make sure you guys can see. So, see? Dry ice. Woo! Ah! And it ruined up my thing here. What? Ah, delicious. Right? So dry ice, for those of you who don't know, is just frozen carbon dioxide. When you see, it's stuck. And see, now it froze part of my spoon. All that happens is when you put it into any liquid, it sublimates. Well, it always sublimates, which is going from a solid to a gas. But when you put it in liquid, especially warm liquids, it does it a lot faster. And it causes the water around the liquid to condense. So we get the cool smoke effect. It's actually just water vapor. But it gets up your nose and it tingles. Not nearly as bad as wasabi, though, so that's fun. Whew! Hey, look, there's dry ice on the floor. Hot, 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 hot! Okay! Let's go to the danger room! Ugh. So there have been a lot of changes to the Danger Room. I don't know if they've got the prices here. They don't have the prices set here yet. But there are proposed final prices for these items that are on the forums right now. For all of the different rewards that you can get. Oh, excuse me. There aren't proposals yet, at least not that I've seen, for purchasing the scenarios. But even so... the biggest thing is the loot. The loot has changed drastically, where now we have a whole bunch of guaranteed stuff. It's pretty awesome. Yeah, see, Revenant knows, that's one of the more common uses for, residential uses for dry ice is for the, purposes of Halloween. Alright, so we're gonna try our usual thing here. I've already got, we'll get rid of some of these. So I've already got an epic. Let's try out a couple of cosmics here and see what we can get. Challenge rating 42. I don't know if I really want to try that because that's quite a lot. Especially because enemies take 50% less damage. Okay, we'll try this. Challenge rating 34. That's not bad. So I'm just trying to figure out how this is progressing as far as the difficulty, because apparently the health of the enemies has drastically decreased. So we'll really be able to get a decent comparison of what it was before to what it is now. So again, we are in Cosmic right now. So we'll see how they are. And in addition, we'll check and see how much damage they're doing. Also, they said there's a glitch about the Omega Orbs where XP Orbs are dropping as Omega Orbs. So that's why there's so many Omegas coming around. Okay, well, this doesn't work well. Ouch! Oh, jeez. That was rough. Okay. Yes, you are. Now go get him. Aw, my lemonade. Ah. Haha, I'm hiding. Can't hit me. And we also still have the new defense thing that we had last week as well. So that'll be interesting to see too. And now I'm just sort of trying to see how long it takes them to defeat my turrets, because last time they actually tore through my turrets pretty efficiently. I mean, they're still doing it relatively well, but not nearly as fast as they did last time. So that's kind of nice. Go get them, Groot. Really, Groot? Rolling into the wall. Get him! Groot, you fail! You're a failure. Thanksgiving plans. I have plans for Thanksgiving. I will be purchasing a chicken, cooking it, and eating it. And that's pretty much it. I don't have any other plans. Pretty much all of my coworkers are leaving. The other ones are going to various friends' homes and stuff like that. So I'm just like, okay, I'll hang out at my home then. Whatever. And there's no, like, well, I guess I'll play video games, probably, after I work. I'm gonna get a chicken because turkeys are big and expensive. And a chicken is still poultry, so it counts. And you can still stuff a chicken! Y'all don't even know. You don't know how I roll. Oh, is this a mini-boss? It is! It's a mini-boss! Excellent. So, the mini-bosses are supposedly have decent loot now. So, we'll figure this out. Why are you doing Thanksgiving today, Rev? Is it just because everybody's leaving or something? Ow, ow, ow. Okay. Well, they're doing somewhat less damage, but it still seems like they have too much. It seems like they have too much health. Ow. I mean, this... For a Cosmic, this isn't as bad as it was last week. For sure. Not nearly. But... I don't know. I'm very remiss to say that something is too easy. Or that it should be easier, rather. Simply because the whole point is that we want difficulty, but at the same time there's a line that feels like it's being crossed at some point. And of course I'm just one person, so I can't say a whole lot. But oh, and you did. Yeah, it's I mean, it works. It's nice. It's kind of sad. I wish that I had better plans and more stuff to do, but unfortunately I just don't. So, it's a sad holiday. Maybe I'll do like a Battlefront stream or something like that. Actually, no. Why would I do that? I wouldn't bother. Maybe I'll like post an extra video or something. Because I don't want to do a stream like on Thanksgiving because I don't know what other people are doing. Which isn't to say that, you know, I believe everybody would be forced to watch me, or they'd feel forced to watch me, because you shouldn't, but... Oh man, now the lemonade on the bottom is frozen. Stupid dry ice ruins everything, but makes it so delicious. I defeated too many times, my survival boost was lost. Wee wee wee. Well, cry about it, game. Oh jeez. Oh jeez. Oh jeez. Yeah. That's a pretty common thing. Well, especially with the December holidays coming up, a lot of people save up. They don't leave for Thanksgiving so that they can stay for, so they can leave for the December holidays, whatever they happen to celebrate. Boy, the spawn rates are a lot higher. That's for sure. Oh, yeah, I know that not everyone's from the U.S., but I know that most are. That's the thing, absolutely. That much I do know for sure is that most are U.S.-based. And I very well may. Like, after I go to work. Because I still have to work, unfortunately. I always have to work, though. That's just how I do. This is interesting. I don't even remember what my bonus mission thing is. It's probably something stupid. Whoa, jeez. Whoa, jeez. Whoa, jeez. So this is the part where my turrets tend to get torn to shreds very quickly by the bad guys. And it looks like that's happening again. I'm not even bothering to summon Magik because she has less survivability than my turrets do. And my turrets don't have very much. Ah, man. I mean, I got him down decently, but jeez. Chris Mahana Kwanzaa? Yeah, exactly. Je suis pas American. Yeah. Yeah, like I said, I know that not everybody is, so it might be nice. We'll see. If I do, it would be like the middle of the day here. Maybe later in the evening. I haven't exactly planned out when I'm going to eat. Because, you know, in America, that's what we think about for half of our lives is when we will eat. The other half is what we will eat. So, thankfully, I'm already done with that part. Ah, bubbly. Aw, man. I'm happy that Groot is still here. That's something that hadn't happened in the past. They were relatively easily able to take out Groot. Okay, now I'm curious. Most of you guys have been watching me for a decent amount of time, so you know that my rocket is at least relatively well equipped. Now, do you guys think that based on this and based on what you know about me, that this is too difficult? Because for me, it does seem like it's a little bit too difficult. It's a little bit too tedious in terms of how much health these guys have. It really does. Maybe that's just me. Aw, man, and I'm not playing World of Warcraft. Shoot. And this song comes on. Oh, well. We'll make it work. Like, it still seems like the health is way too high. The damage is tough with Rocket because I've only got a durability of 2. I mean, my damage reduction is only 31%. It's not that high. But at the same time, it's just, I don't know. Seems a little much. This is one of those things where I'm very excited to see this happening, and I'm glad that the mode's here, and really I'm happy that we're doing so much testing for it. I would rather have, you know, 6 weeks of good solid testing to really get it well tuned rather than have it go on live and make it completely non-worthwhile to actually do. Okay, so that was one of the lieutenants. Oh, okay, I got one of the lieutenants already. Cool, it must have been that other guy. See, this is the problem with dying too much, is you tend to lose sight of exactly what you're supposed to be doing. And I've got additional missions on this one, too. Bummer. We'll try it. I mean, the tediousness really still feels like it's here. Arbitrary increases in health for the bad guys does not equate to more difficult. Have more bad guys, have more damage, may force you to move around more, force you to, you know, like, change up your strategies just a little bit, but the problem is, I know for a lot of players, difficulty essentially comes down to, you know, this boss has a lot of health and does a lot of damage, and now it's hard. But, it's just... For me, that's just not true, and I mean, you see how long this is, and I am very scared because first off, I've got duplicate boss as one of the modifiers, and when I get to the boss, I seriously worry that it's going to end up being like Sauron was last time. Where, you guys remember that, where I was fighting him for a good, like, almost half hour in a purple scenario. And I literally could not kill him because he kept healing. I did not have the damage output to kill him. It was awful. Like, see, this is not fun. This is not interesting. This doesn't excite me for this mode. Here, see, look at this. See, all my lemonade's frozen at the bottom. Ah! I feel like I'm at Six Flags and got frozen lemonade. Yay! IR did the thing. And I've got so many Omegas now. And that's the problem. Like, I don't want to have to, you know, like, look really, really closely at the screen and at their health bars to know whether or not I'm actually progressing in the scenario. That's just... No. I don't want to. Oh, this song. Shoot. I just realized that. So, if you guys have seen the stuff on YouTube, whenever I post these on YouTube, then sometimes they get blocked in a lot of countries, and this is actually one of the worst songs for it, because this song blocks... videos in like 300 countries. It blocks it all over the world, essentially. So I might have to just chop this part out. So if anybody has evidence of alien life, sorry. Yay! So see, finishing this optional event thing got me right about halfway done. And the problem is now it's basically just a grind. I remember the original way that they had it is you had to complete the little mission in here, and now they've made it optional, and you just have this arbitrary progress bar. But I think that if you complete the mission, it should do more than just get you halfway to completion. I think that it should give you at least like 2/3 or 3/4, so that it really feels like you made more of a difference. But maybe that's me. Maybe I'm just crazy like that. There you go, Revenant. Now you have successfully proven that P equals NP. Oh my god, it's a miracle! However, it is only for well-defined values of P and NP. So, I don't know. If any of you are wondering about the nerding out that's taking place right now, PNP is it's a very famous unsolved problem in computer science, if I'm not mistaken. Revenant might know more about it than I do, but it's a very famous unsolved problem where you have two different aspects of, like I said, if I'm not mistaken, it's computational algorithms, or not algorithms, but computational variables. And thus far, it has been unproven that they can be equivalent to one another. I don't know. Now I'm going to have to look it up at some point. But either way, I'm not a comp sci person. I'm a life sci person. So I don't know these things. I'm not meant to. See, this song, this is my jam right here. This is the song about me, basically. PNP doesn't get a song. They're not cool enough. Get 'em. So see, this scenario is not bad. Or this simulation, I should say. This simulation isn't half bad. I'm doing decently against the enemies. I haven't died. But the enemies go down quickly enough that I feel like I'm actually progressing efficiently. I mean, I finished up the optional mission fairly quickly. But yeah. Stop the proofs before I have an aneurysm. Oh, you're fine, alternate warning. No worries. You know what I'm gonna do? Sorry. I got some of my stuff on my controller here. Ah! I pulled up Steam! No! Go away! Good thing we don't have controller support yet, or I'd be like jumping around all over. Whoa, what? Oh god, what did I do? I broke it! Oh my god, I don't know what I'm doing! Get me out! The fudge did I do, man? I don't know if you guys saw any of that, but it seriously freaked me out. Because Steam was up and it, like, I actually started up the, what is essentially the Steam machine program and the Steam stream or whatever it's called, so that you can play it on your couch. And because I kept just pressing random buttons on the controller that's hooked up to my computer, and it started it up. And I don't know what it was, and it freaked me out. Sorry, it's okay now. I'm back. The good news is the controller still works after having been slightly covered in dry ice infused lemonade, because that's how he rolls. All right, so this is the other issue that I had with the danger room, and it actually goes to what I was saying earlier as well, where now that I'm done with the main mission, it's optional. The problem now is that I have to track down enough bad guys to finish filling out the progress bar. And in the previous one, the spawn rate was so ridiculously high that I could literally just walk around any corner and there'd be a whole bunch of bad guys there just waiting for me. But here, not so much. We already heard this song. Where is my Chrome? There we go. Oh, I don't have my Hulk costume on. Man. Be so much better. Ow. See, that's what happens when you try to rock out while you're doing a stream. You get kilt. Yes, alternate warning. It is a Ferris wheel. A very fun Ferris wheel. It's very exciting. I actually have like three of these. Because I keep doing the things where you get like random shirts. Like random old shirts from the company for like $8 a piece. And I've gotten a bunch of duplicates of this one. It's not a bad thing. It's just a fact. Despite all my rage, I'm still just a rat in a game. In case you're wondering, no, we do not play this for the animals in the lab. We do not do that. Because mostly because they wouldn't get the joke. But also because nobody would really appreciate it. And also it's kind of cruel to the animals. We don't do that. Aya Cook would not approve of playing rock music to your animals. Well, they might if you had a good reason for it. Sure there's some good reason. See, this is taking way too long. But now, the problem is I really want to complete this. I want to complete the cosmic because I want to see if the loot is implemented. So, apparently, now for the awesome loot. And incidentally, I'm not looking at the game right now. I'm actually on the Marvel Heroes forums here. So, apparently, with a cosmic scenario, I should get another scenario. Pure Elements, Cosmic Insignia, Cosmic Ring, two cores that have four stats, two uniques, an unstable molecule, maybe a black box, 90 merits, and then whatever bonus merits I'm entitled to. So that's a lot of stuff. The problem is, you know, I'm thinking about this like, okay, the Cosmic Insignia particularly is good, but... I mean, is it worth it? Like, Bovenheim you can complete in, what, 20 minutes? Maybe? I mean, if you skip past all the other cows. And that's essentially a guaranteed uniques. And it just seems like it's not really equivalent here. Clearly, I'm spending a lot more time on this, and the rewards are not going to be comparative. Now, why is there a taxi in the middle of the subway? How on earth does that make sense? So we're trying to destroy subway assets right now. That's why I'm going around. We'll see. This is probably going to be another one of these scenarios that barely... gives me any completion overall. I'm happy that I'm able to use the med kits this time because the last few times that was one of the challenges I had. Oh man, I just not having med kit use is crippling. And the problem is it's crippling for many, many heroes, not just Rocket. But a decent number of heroes easily die without medkits. One thing that I would personally really like to see on this is, depending on how many... or what the challenge rating is, you can potentially change the rewards. Because that's really mostly what it's about. Who's putting ICP in this? We're not on ICP, okay, guys? We are in the danger room, not ICP, guys. Seriously, have some respect. Crazy people. This whole trial does not make sense. This is Chewbacca. Chewbacca is a Wookiee. Wookiees come from Kashyyyk. But Chewbacca lives on Endor. Why does he do that? That did not make sense. Oh, God, it's so amazing. That makes me kind of want to play, what's it called? Battlefront. I have to admit, Battlefront is not terrible. It's not awful. I won't talk about it though, because I'm sure that many people hate it. I didn't complete the thing yet, did I? I couldn't have. So this is one thing I would love to have is a tracker for these. Like put it in the tracker and say how many I've done. Because I saw the 25 and the 50. So I should be pretty close, but... Seriously, how can a car survive a fleet slayer? That makes no sense. That does not make sense. That does not make sense. Now I have to go through and just find, like, random subway assets to destroy. Haha! Yes! I did it! Made Ford tough? You mean like the Ford Bronco? Perhaps? God, that reminds me of, what's it called? Arrested Development. When George Sr. was trying to get away and he went to the Ford dealership. And he was like, yeah, we don't sell the Bronco anymore. We're trying to get away from that whole runaway fugitive thing. Oh, well, what's this one called? This is called the Escape. And it's true! It's hilarious! But I hadn't thought about it until I watched that episode. It was awesome. Sorry, that was off track. Ugh. And let me say again, I do apologize about missing Monday. I hope that you guys didn't miss me too much. And unfortunately, it was a good reason and it was a fun time, but alas, not worthwhile in the end. Very sad. Oh, quiet, Jukercha. Nobody asked you. It was hilarious and you know it. I gotta find those mini-bosses, because... See, we're having the same problem again! Need some slightly better balance here, folks. Oh, that's terrible! Oh, Revenant! Oh, not cool, man. Not cool. Wow. You're a bad person. You know, and I just watched, well, again, for like the 20th time, the epic rap battles of history with Jim Henson and Stan Lee. Man, not cool, man. Not cool. I think the content for the game is very short. Well, that's tough. It's a tough thing to say. I mean, with the Danger Room coming in, we will have a lot more and a lot longer stuff, but by and large, yes. Particularly some of the endgame stuff. It was designed for the purpose of not needing a lot. So the best example is the raids, where, you know, if you look at some of the classic raid games, like World of Warcraft is obviously the biggest one, then, you know, you've got raids that go on for hours and hours and hours, and you have raid groups that play 12 hours straight. Whenever the raids were implemented in Marvel Heroes, one thing that people were worried about is that it would be similar. So the developers deliberately tried to avoid that and make it so that you can still have the raids and you can still have the big epic boss battles, but they're not so big and they're not so crazy in that sense that you need to, you know, set aside a work shift in order to do it. And it's kind of the same thing with the Danger Room. That's how they're designing it, where the whole point is you come in, you do like one or two, you get it done in like an hour and a half probably. And, you know, you feel good, you get some new items, hopefully you have a good time. It's really the idea. Oh yeah, hours. Yeah. You haven't seen some of the stuff with the WoW raids, alternate warning? It's ridiculous. It's absolutely insane. Some of those guys are nuts. So for me, I did it once or twice. I used to play WoW. I wasn't in like a major raid guild, but we were good enough that we did raid and we had some pretty big raids, and it was fun. But oh god, it is so taxing. It really is. It just takes like the life force directly out of you. It's pretty difficult. But again, you know, it can be very rewarding, and if you do it well, if you do it right, then, you know, more power to you. But I mean, some of these guys, they're very intense about the rating, and that's one of the things that Marvel Heroes actively wanted to avoid, was having that kind of commitment required just in order to play the game. So I know that's like a really roundabout way of answering the question there, Z3 Fire. But that's really what it comes down to, is that yes, the content is shorter, but it is by design that it is. And if you want the longer game experience, I mean, essentially you end up having to grind, which does kind of suck. But the raids, depending on how good your group is, can be a little bit longer. But once you get a really good group and everybody knows what they're doing and how to do it, I mean, you can complete the easiest raid in 10 or 15 minutes, and you could probably knock out the most difficult raid in, what would you guys say, maybe like half hour at most, potentially. It's really not that bad. So, I don't know. Oh, shoot. If this is the one that I think it is, it's one where I can't really destroy the crates. Because it's just ludicrous. Revenant, we was hardcore. Oh, yeah, buddy, you were hardcores. And the thing is, I don't know how it's defined, but, like, thinking back on... Just as a random thing that I thought of that's somewhat relevant, in a Super Size Me, apparently at the time at least, McDonald's defined a heavy user as somebody who ate there every day, and then a super heavy user was somebody who ate at McDonald's multiple times a day. Again, I don't know if that's actually accurate, but that's what he said in the documentary. So I think you could make a similar argument for video games, you know, as far as being hardcore or not hardcore or whatever it is. That's almost philosophical, though. I really don't want to go into that. I just want to destroy this weapon shipment. The health on this is much, much better than it was, but you can see it's still pretty slow. I know you guys can't actually see what I'm pointing at, but I'm pointing at the health bar below complete simulation. Like, this should not take so long. It shouldn't take me more than like 10 or 15 seconds to really get this down. Oh yeah, that's very true, Revenant. But that doesn't mean that all of the facts are incorrect, and that's why I just mentioned that single aspect in terms of what McDonald's may or may not have said. Again, I don't know if that's actually accurate, but I just use it as an analogy for this. I just feel sorry for the people who were trying to reproduce his results. Yum. My ice attacked me. Ice! Ice, ice, baby. Seriously, stupid weapon shipment? You're not supposed to take this long. That's it. Man, it's so anticlimactic. This is going to be interesting. So if you guys remember, last time I had this exact same scenario, the destroy the weapon shipments in, I believe it was also a cosmic. And I could not finish it at all because of this. Because we had these giant groups of bad guys, they would tear directly through my turrets. I didn't have a single chance. This is certainly better. I'm still having a tough time. I'm still having to really dance around. But not bad. Okay, super heavy, that's what I thought. Hey! I mean, the big groups definitely still pose quite a threat to me. Which, again, isn't really bad. I mean, they should. You know, if you've got a lot of bad guys, regardless of how much health they have, then they should pose some kind of threat to you. Incidentally, one thing that's interesting about this is the damage reduction is actually based off of... like, that's the percentage of things that... the percentage of damage that you negate when you're hit by an enemy of your level. Which is something interesting to think about because, you know, endgame content, while it takes place at player level 60, all of the enemies are 63. So that's what a lot of people have been asking for a good while is, you know, how does it change with regard to higher level enemies? Or can we just get something like that? I would love to have something that just said, you know, what my damage reduction is for a specific, like, if we had level groupings or whatever. So, like, 10 or more below, 5 to 10 below, you know, 0 to 5 below, or 1 to 5 below, 0, like, even, and then do the same thing above. So, I think that would be more helpful than simply saying, like, look, this is the damage reduction that you have with bad guys that are your level. I just find that a lot less relevant, especially for endgame content. And see, again, it's just... what fudge? You know, I think this should be... and see, the... my blaster turrets don't even recognize it as a bad guy. They're not even shooting at it. this is something where it seems like something along the lines of ICP's dino shipments would be good, because with those you just go in and you basically like poke them and they're down. Now, maybe not necessarily that bad, but this is too much. This is utterly unnecessary. But you know what the thing is? Now I'm like really seriously committed to actually finishing out this scenario. So we're totes gonna do it, guys. Ah! Ah! Don't shoot me! Oh, jeez! Ah, respawns! Save me, turrets! Oh, it's gone. Ah, run away! Brave Sir Rocket ran away. Bravely ran away. Yeah, and that's what I mean. These boxes should not be that difficult to destroy. Any kind of box. Maybe if it's made of, like, adamantium. But seriously, you're going to waste all that adamantium making a box? Like, that makes sense? For your fancy giant criminal organization. I'm sad I'm out of lemonade. And look, I didn't even need the last one. Wham. So sad. Oh, Christ. Oh, God, of all things. Of all the bosses in the entire game... it had to be not only one that has the worst HP levels, but one that I personally can't stand. I think it's ironic because they're all diminutive, though. Oh, God. This is going to be awful, guys. You should probably go and, you know, like, make a souffle or something. Maybe by that time I'll be halfway done. When your ultimate is doing this little damage, there is a serious problem with your HP balance. Not PH balance. That's totally fine. We got that taken care of. But your HP balance. See that? See, that is a science joke right there for you guys. You're welcome. I'll be here all night. Tip your waitresses. Sorry. Oh, God. And there's two of them. That's the best part, is there's two. And the problem is there's really not a danger of me dying on this one. Joker Chaw, why you gotta be mean like that, man? Why you gotta be that guy? Not cool, bro. Not cool. Hello to you until you get it on the white light going low. I don't got no fire! I can't kill with fire! I ain't got none! I think the one nice thing is that it seems at least that they share an HP bar. So that's good. Absolutely! The developers of Marvel Heroes need to work on their Harry Potter balance. It makes no sense! Why is Harry Potter always so strong, and why does he get out of trouble all the time? He always does all this stupid stuff, but then they're just like, oh wait, never mind, you saved the school. It's all good, bro. Now, just go ahead and go back to your abusive family. Yeah, that's fine. Gah, magical community is terrible. And that's what I said, like, the one good thing about this is that they share... they share an HP bar. If it wasn't for that, this whole thing would be awful. Terrible. Luke Skywalker killed him in death battle? Aww, that's not nice. I actually haven't watched any of that. I don't know what it is. Doesn't ring a bell. Overall opinion is that it's pretty good, but balance could still be better. So, I actually don't know what the overall opinion is. I haven't read much on the forums, as far as the exact feedback that other people are getting, but certainly for me personally, it's in a much, much better place than it was, like, what, so I did it last week and it was pretty bad, and then... a few weeks before that. So, oh wow! I got hit with, like, part of his little ice blast thing and I died. That was just impressive. Come on, Groot, quit standing around like a bump on a log! Ha! See, I told you guys I'd be here all night. Y'all have to deal. Sucks to be you. Get it, cause Groot basic. Never mind. Y'all are lame. Do I think the Danger Room might come before Thanksgiving? It might. I will say that it's very, very close. I do like what they've done with it. The bigger issue right now is that they're trying to incorporate both a fairly complex new game mode with the Danger Room, but at the same time they're also doing the complete revamping of the defense system. And because they're trying to do both of those at the same time, it means that there's potentially a lot of breakage that might happen. Yay! I don't know why I would bother collecting all this stuff. Look at all my Omega points! Whee! I can't believe... So, this is actually the first time that I have successfully completed a cosmic scenario since they started revamping everything. Because before, when I very, very first started trying this out, it was way too easy. And essentially, the... what's it called? The cosmic scenarios were essentially not quite red terminals, maybe like a little bit more difficult than that, but I mean, just about on par with cosmics. It was pretty rough. That's kind of cool. See, now it actually labels them. So you see, this is plus two additional missions with the scenario modifier, so I get a bonus chest for that, and then Danger Room Riches. So let's see what's in the bonus chest first. Okay, so the bonus is exactly that. It is just bonus stuff. It's not the same as the riches. So let's see if the riches have been modified yet. Oh, that's unfortunate. I got 130 merits, though. That's cool, I guess, or whatever. And a staple gun. That was utterly disappointing. So, part of this, like I said, one thing that I really wanted to test was Azros on the forums posted this big giant thing of, for every level of the scenarios, here's what you would get from the main chest. And I guess they just didn't implement it, but this is what they will be having. So I mentioned earlier that for the cosmic one, it would be a scenario that's epic or below. Pure elements, a cosmic insignia, a cosmic ring, two costume cores that each have four stats, and then two uniques, unstable molecule, potentially getting a black box, the Danger Room black box, the 90 merits, which we did see, and then any bonus merits that you're entitled to. So, I mean, overall, it would have been nice to see that implemented. I think that it works relatively well. So this is the Danger Room black box here. This is essentially all of the new items that are Danger Room specific. And I think you can actually purchase them individually as well. So, like, see, this is the Cyclops Was Right t-shirt. Ah, oh, how cool would that be? I can have I could be wearing a Cyclops Was Right t-shirt while I'm playing in the group of Magneto Was Right. Oh, man, I'd be so meta. It would hurt. Sorry. Really? This song again? I've got like 80 songs on my playlist, but it keeps replaying a bunch of them. Shouldn't have to replay songs, fascist cow. Alright. So here, this Sinister's Diamond. Very, very nice for energy people. The Fist of Apocalypse. Good because, you know, relatively few artifacts give you attribute modifiers, so that's kind of nice. The Tanya's love letter is pretty awesome with the fighting. Can't really go wrong with that. I mean, there's some pretty decent stuff here. And then, of course, all the different class rings of various sorts and several unique items as well. So really, not bad. Not bad stuff. So let's go ahead and try this. So we just did a cosmic scenario. So let's try an epic one. Okay. Training scenario. Wait, what? Ah, let me out! I'm lost! I'm cold and frightened! I'm awaiting the first challenge. Challenge accepted! Wait, seriously? Really? This is the... Really? This is the training scenario? Wait. Yeah, I did it! Go me. It's my birthday. Not really. Oh. Yes, this is Test Center. Yes, it is. And that is Evil Meryl. He's already evil, we all know that. Doombots! I don't see no Doombots. It's because they all scared. Oh! Oh, jeez! Okay! They're slightly less scared than I expected. Okay, this is boring. I'm out. I want to try an epic scenario. Alright. Okay. Okay, we can do that. So I just want to see how this compares. Really, the subway?
Again?
So we just completed the Cosmic, and you guys saw it was relatively difficult. Excuse me. See, this is one of the new songs I added. That's what I'm talking about. Wait, what? Clean bags? What are you talking about? What are you talking about, Revenant? See, now all the carbonation is like bubbly in my stomach and it's making me burp. It's hilarious. Oh, my inventory. Oh yeah, that one time. I'm pretty sure I was doing it as a demonstration of inventory. I am a busy man, Revenant. I can't be bothered to be cleaning out my inventory like every 2 days, okay? I got stuff to do, yo. Plus, this is on Test Center. Y'all don't know what I look like on live. You know, I'm super awesome on live. Y'all don't know. Whatever. You don't know me. You don't know my struggles. All right. No, Revenant, it is not exactly the same. Okay? Shut up. It's way better on live. You don't even know. Okay? You don't even know. God. I flip my hair at you. Ugh. I can't flip well. Okay, so see, now in this epic scenario, the weapon shipments still have far too much health, considering that they're boxes! Get them, Groot! I think part of the problem is that my summons don't recognize them as bad. Why would I play a Squirrel Girl ever? Much less forever. That's a terrible idea. That is the worst idea anyone has ever had, ever. Come on, Magik. Attack the box. Seriously, attack the boxes. It's probably more efficient than attacking the darkness. Attacking the darkness is just worthless. FYI. So, this level of difficulty, this level of, like, punishment for the scenario. This is good. I like this. The enemies are clearly dangerous, but they're defeated relatively quickly, so I can move forward at least somewhat efficiently here. This is very, very nice. I like this. I think that this one, the epic, tuned up slightly, just a smidge, would be perfect for the cosmics. Because it's right on that edge of, like, I do feel like I'm in danger, I do feel like I need to pay attention. Because if I don't, then I know that they'll take me down. But at the same time, I have an appropriate amount of, like, okay, I'm able to move through this. And not sit there for 10 minutes attacking boxes. Or the darkness, as the case may be. Y'all just jealous of my inventory? You'll see! You'll see on Monday, I'll do my stream and it'll be awesome. And I won't even fix it over the weekend. Yeah. I'm not gonna do nothing over the weekend. It's just gonna be awesome. And y'all are gonna be super jealous. And then y'all are gonna Hey, what? Da fudge! This is awesome! This is the first time I've ever seen this aspect of the scenario. That's so cool! Some infection. The worst is behind. See, this kind of stuff would be perfect to have more of. Like, have slightly more variety in the maps. I know that it's difficult because it takes a lot of effort to... the ragdolls. I know it takes a lot of effort to make these new areas or expand the old areas, whatever it happens to be. But at the same time, like, this is really cool. This is awesome. You've never been in here before. And it's fun. Oh, quiet, Jigger-cha. Douche. You're a bad person. Boom! Did you see that giant jump that we got towards the scenario completion when I defeated the bad lady? Bad person? When I defeated her, I had a jump that was a decent amount over half the bar, and that was just from defeating a single person, a single entity. Oh, Jukercha, you knew what this was. You knew what this was. So I'm thinking that after this, after I'm done with this scenario, I'm going to head out for the day, unfortunately. Because I've got work to do and hopes to, well, hope about. So that probably won't happen. Also, there's beer to drink. Because it's... noon. It's afternoon. That means it's okay to drink. I know. I'm a terrible person. It's okay. You don't have to use me as a role model. I know it's Saturday. That's why it's okay to drink in the afternoon. I'm just saying. I still have to go to work, though. I'll drink after work. Fine! I'll be all responsible and adult-like. Whatever. Guys suck. Take away all my fun. Wow, this thing is huge! I don't know, 5 a.m. on Monday, that seems like it's cutting it a bit too close for my tastes. And also, 12 p.m. on Friday, like, really? Really? That's... yeah. No. That's too early. Do 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 do. All right, guys, are you ready for the awesome part of the song? You should be, because it's almost here. Ouch! Okay. Okay, we're fine. We're still fine. See, this is what happens when you get distracted by sticks. Or any other band, really. Oh, man. I've said it before and I'll say it again. I love the potential of the Danger Room. If we can get that just right balance for having everything just right, it's compared to some of the other modes, it's easy to expand. I mean, you can have all sorts of cool scenarios, all sorts of cool, the challenges, the hazards, all that kind of stuff. It's like, I can see so much going on with this. And again, this is why I'm glad that they're doing all this testing, because I would prefer it to be released in as finished a state as possible. But like, again, this epic scenario, I like this. This is good. I feel like I'm making progress. I feel like I can defeat the bad guys. Really? The Mega Sentinel again? Really? You're going to Bogart me like that, game? Really? And you got the duplicates, and they're gargantuan now. So this is just revenge. That's what you're saying, right? Wow. Yeah. No. Nah, it's totally cool. Whatever. I don't freaking care. Nobody cares. Yes, we do need the Eric Cartman version. That would be amazing. Although it's much shorter. So there you go. Yeah, that's why I said, like, this, I mean, even for epic, like, as an epic scenario, this is pretty good. I still can't do any damage to the stupid Mega Sentinels, but still. Man, and thank our lucky stars for the shared health bar. Wait, was the Mega Sentinel cursing there for a second? Had like all the various punctuation marks that indicate he may have been cursing. I'm just saying. Yay! IR Gaming! Woohoo! Oh god! No! You did! Awesome! They don't have the one from the show, though. The one from the show is way more hilarious. Because he sings the whole song in like 10 seconds. Alright, so I get my bonus. So there, see, there's the survival bonus chest. See, that was not bad at all. That only took, what, 15 or 20 minutes? Oh, yeah, the Omega points. It's absolutely hilarious. I have, like, all the Omega points now. Oh, are they not counting? Man! They're not counting as Omega points. Also, this is on Test Center, so it makes no difference anyway. All right. Because we have to finish listening to Cartman, let's try the absolute easiest. High impact throwable cars. Oh, too bad I can't throw cars. So just as a point of comparison, this is the easiest level of the scenario. What's my mission? The song of hope. This is what they say. They say, come sail away. Come sail away. Come sail away with me. You guys. Oh, it is working. I just have that few omegas. Oh, that makes me so sad. So see, in this scenario, I'll be able to finish in, you know, like 5 minutes. So very easy. And see, I like this because this is kind of the point where we've got this very, very easy level of being able to do this relatively quickly. Just get some merits, essentially, is the idea. For those curious, the proposed rewards for the common is just 2 random pure elements and then merits, and that's it. There wouldn't be anything else that you earn from these. I don't know if I'd even say this is Cosmic Terminal. I mean, maybe. We'll see how the boss is. We'll see the boss. Okay, so that was a decent amount of damage that the elite guys did to me. I mean, it seems like the damage is lower compared to Cosmic's, but that might just be me. That's what it seems. I'm just trying to track down these idols so I can get that done quickly and efficiently. That was awesome. See, that is how fast I think they should all be destroyed, regardless of your scenario level. Because it's not like it's going anywhere. It's not fighting against you. It's just a rock. And, I mean, sure, I could stand there for 10 minutes and try to do it, but, yeah, no. Alright, so let's get this last one. It's not going to fill out my bar, but it'll be close at least. Bow, 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 bow. Sing a song for the broken heart. All right. Okay. See, and now I'm seriously thinking Thanksgiving Day Battlefront stream. That'd be fun. I've wanted to stream Battlefront. I think it would be cool. Especially now that I actually played it a little bit and it's not awful. I have had some fun. I've only played the single player stuff. And it's actually pretty good. It's not great, it's not amazing, it's no Battlefront 2. Galactic Conquest. Ugh! I would kill for Galactic Conquest. But even so, it's not as bad as I thought it would be. Wink! So, the way that I see it, it seems that the damage for this level of scenario is a little bit higher than in a Cosmic Terminal, like the damage the enemies do, but their health seems lower. Just a little bit lower. Not much. Eliminate Gorgon. Oh, Hans Briggs. Breaking my bars. Alright, so let's see how this works. I don't have my ult. I thought I did. So this is definitely going faster than Cosmic Terminals. Definitely going faster. That's great. The first time that I get Danger Room scenarios are from a common Danger Room scenario. And I get two of them. Terrible. Alright, so let's see our survival. No Cosmics, not really surprising, but still. And then, yeah. So there's our little merits. And that's it. So sad. So very sad. But again, that was just a common one, and I did that in literally about 5 minutes, right? So, not bad for what it is. But like I said, unfortunately, I actually got to get going now, guys. So thanks so much, as always, for being here. I will be back on Monday, at least as of right now. I don't believe that anything is going to happen, unfortunately. So I should be here on Monday at the regular time, and then potentially doing a Thanksgiving stream next Thursday. That's U.S. Thanksgiving, not Canadian, because I'm, a month and a half late on that. But as always, thank you guys so much for being here. Hopefully you liked it. Sorry again about Monday, this past Monday, but hopefully I will see you next Monday. And hopefully you enjoyed the test center. I know I didn't mess with Magik too much, but Danger Room looking much, much better than it did.